Baldur or Baldur is one of the Ezer gods. He's loved by all the gods, goddesses, and beings of a more physical nature. The meaning and etymology of his name are uncertain and have been the topic of intense scholarly debate, as with his personality as a god. Numerous possibilities have been proposed, including a derivation from the Proto-Indo-European root bal, white, Old Norse bal, fire, or a hypothesized word for lord common to various Germanic languages. The most straightforward, and probably correct, explanation, however, is that his name comes from the Old Norse word baldr, which means bold. Scholars have been reluctant to accept this explanation due to its implication of a warlike character for Baldur, as the medieval Danish historian Saxo Grammaticus view him to be. Baldur may not have been as innocent and passive as he's portrayed to be in the late Old Norse literary source, the prose of the prose Edda of the medieval Icelandic scholar Snorri Sturluson, that provides the most extensive description of the god and the tales in which he features. Baldur was a god of truth and light. Baldur was also knowledgeable in healing herbs and runes, which made him a favorite among the people of Midgard. Everyone loved to be around Baldur. Wherever he went and whoever he spent his time with, the encounter was inevitably joyous. Baldur lived in a palace named Breidablik with his wife Nanu, a vegetation goddess, daughter of the god Nep, and son Fasiti, the god of justice. It was believed that no light could pass through the walls of Breidablik, home of the god of truth. Baldur is depicted as a tall and handsome man with long hair and a thick beard. He is muscular and wears only a loincloth and a cape. Some paintings, perhaps from later interpretations, also show him with armor or a tunic, but the bare-chested version seems more popular today. Baldur can be seen with a shield and a spear, but not often in a stance ready for battle, showing that he is not a warlike god. He appears with his spear pointing downwards, and his shield standing on the ground. Baldur is one of the two sons of Odin and Frigg, the second wife and favorite of Odin. He had a twin brother by the name of Hordr, who was blind. Odin spent much of his time drinking with his feasting and fighting companions and the Valkyries in Valhalla, famous home of valiant warriors. He is said to have stopped feasting when he heard about the inevitable doom of Ragnarok, Norse apocalypse. His fears was further strengthened when Baldur started having frightening nightmares about his own demise. The other Ezer gods took them seriously. Unlike gods in other pantheons, the Norse gods were not immortal. Fearing that these dreams were prophetic, they sought a solution to prevent his death from coming to pass. Odin took up the task of finding a final solution. Odin got on his horse, Sleipnir, and literally hoofed it to the underworld, where a deceased female seer resided. When Odin got there, in disguise, the underworld was decorated and set for a party. The seeress had foreseen Baldur's death and they were preparing a suitable welcome for someone of this status. Odin told Frigg about what was prophesied to befall their son. They catalogued everything that might possibly harm Baldur, from weapons to diseases to creatures. With the list in hand, Frigg set out to exact assurances from everything in the Nine Worlds not to harm Baldur, which wasn't hard because he was so universally loved. When she had completed her mission, Frigg returned to Gladsheim, the gods' meeting hall, for a celebration from which the gods decided to test Baldur's invulnerability. From small objects to larger weapons used, none could hurt the god. Loki, the god of mischief, saw this as a great opportunity. He went to Frigg while she was at Fenslea taking a break from the festivities in the guise of an old hag, and with his trickery inquired of her if she really got an oath from everything in the cosmos. Frigg revealed that the exception was the mistletoe, since she could see no way it would be dangerous. With this information, Loki set off to the forest to get himself a branch of mistletoe. He then returned to the festivities at Gladsheim and sought out Baldur's blind brother, Pod, god of darkness, who was in a corner because he couldn't aim and therefore couldn't participate in the test of Baldur's invulnerability. Loki told Hod he would help him take aim and handed Hod a piece of apparently innocuous mistletoe to throw. Hod was grateful and accepted the offer, so Loki steered Hod's arm. Hod launched the branch, which caught Baldur in the chest. Baldur died instantly. The gods looked towards Hod and saw Loki beside him. However, Loki fled away before they could do anything. Celebration turned to lamentation since the most beloved of the gods had died. Odin alone was aware of how disastrous this event really was for them all, for he knew that with the loss of light and truth, the end of the world, Ragnarok, was due soon. A funeral pyre was made that was so enormous the gods had to ask the help of the giants. They then placed their most valuable worldly possessions as gifts upon the pyre. Odin placed his golden armband Rapnir. Baldur's wife fell down dead of grief at the pyre, so her body was placed beside her husband's. After their funeral, they were in the world called Niflheim, the underworld. An attempt was made to resurrect Baldur. Another son of Odin, Hermod, volunteered to ride Sleipnir to the underworld and beg him, the goddess, to return him. All agreed to it on the condition that all in the cosmos must weep for Baldur. Loki, once again frustrated this plan, since he in the guise of the giantess, Thok, refused to shed a tear. Baldur could not return to the land of the living. Baldur and his wife remained in Niflheim until Ragnarok. Baldur's death was avenged by slaying his blind brother Byvali, another son of Odin. Loki, the trickster god, was eventually captured. He had tried to get to safety after appearing in the guise of the giantess Thok by turning into a salmon. The salmon Loki hid in a waterfall. But the Ezer, who knew where he was, tried to catch him in a net. Loki was too clever and jumped right over the net. Thor, however, was fast enough to catch the leaping fish in his bare hands. Then Loki was bound in a cave with venom dripping onto his body, which caused him to writhe in pain until the world's end in Ragnarok.